Well, we got stranded yesterday on the freeway. Going to take Monet. We was going to go pick up Monet to take her for her driver's test again. But we end up getting stranded. My serpentine belt. All my lights turned on like the day before I went to work. And when I went to work, did my 12-hour shift, came back, you know, got home, went home. The lights are still all on the dashboard. They all was lit up. Didn't know what was going on until the next day. I got on up and was about to take her. Me and Kaden was about to take her to go take her for a driver's test. And come to find out, it was, I couldn't turn. I couldn't turn my wheel. The air conditioner went out. I'm like, okay, what the hell is going on? Air conditioner went out. I couldn't turn my wheel to get to the different lane. So I'm just struggling trying to turn. I put my hazard lights on. I just came right on up. Came up on Camelback and took that on down to 99. Called my hubby and he was at work. He had just went to work. So I called Jeremiah. And Jeremiah, he ended up leaving work, coming to pick us up because it was so hot outside. My hubby called the tow truck, but we ended up just saying, okay, we'll just get it done or whatever the next morning. So we made it. We here the next day, and Silver Fox is down. I just want to show y'all. Silver Fox don't have a belt. So what happened was the belt shredded, and that's what caused all the lights to come on the dashboard and things was out of whack and out of control. So the no air conditioner, no nothing, because the serpentine belt ended up shredding. So I wanted to show you guys. Y'all see that? That serpentine belt is gone, shredded. And yeah, look at that. Thank God we made it safely. Thank God we made it safely. I almost fell. Thank God we made it safely. It was me and Kaden. So we ended up getting us some, what's that? That Korean barbecue? Hawaiian barbecue. Which was pretty good. So we went and got that. But we right here at the Home Depot, thank God. We just kept it here all night. And we ended up just coming, going home. Then hubby right here came to got us. Hubby came brung us today, this morning. We ended up getting up or whatever, called in a tow truck. So we ended up calling the tow truck. So we just now waiting for the tow truck now to come. So that was our day. You know, just more money. More problems, more money. More money, more problems. Don't have money, we don't have money. What it's a spare to spend, but how can I be able to get back and forth to work without a car? So that's what we up against. It's like this economy is really burning us. We think the sun is burning us, but the economy is really, really burning us. With this inflation, I mean, everybody's going through it. Everybody's going through this inflation. Everybody's going through money issues, working overtime, double time, triple time, and working 10 jobs, you know, just to make ends meet. I'm tired of it. I know y'all tired of it. And it's just like, you know, we don't know where to turn to. We don't know where to turn to because we don't know who to vote. Don't let me get onto voting. Don't know who we want to vote for. If the person that we vote for, Trump, Kamala, you know what I'm saying? Are they going to give us justice? Are they going to give us humanity? Are they going to make sure that, you know what I'm saying, we could be able to afford things, bring our jobs, and inflations or whatever, bring our inflation down to where it used to be. I don't understand, but this is really, really getting on our nerves. I just wanted to come in here and tell you guys that, yeah, Betsy is down. She's a little dusty. She's really dusty now, but I'm trying to get her back together. We just got the windshield fixed. As soon as we get the windshield fixed, thanks to my son and Monet, they got the windshield fixed for me. But as soon as we get the windshield fixed, then here comes something else. And that something else is this serpentine belt. I also do have an oil leak, and that's probably caused it, because when we did take it into for service or oil change, they was telling us that we did have an oil leak, a small oil leak. And that probably, through the times or whatever, throughout the time of driving, it loosened up that belt. And when it loosened up the belt, the oil got to that belt and it loosened it up. More on business to start shredding. And maybe it was just time for a serpentine belt. But yeah, that's one good thing about, you know, I don't have a car note. I just paid this car off. It's a 2013 Verano, Buick Verano, but I just paid it off. So I'm proud and I'm thankful that I don't have a car note anymore. So, you know what I'm saying, I'm able to, and my husband able to get little things or whatever fixed on it, you know. But if I had a car note, it'd be something else. But thank God I don't have a car note, and, you know, we just paid the insurance here. So I just wanted to come out here and tell you guys, yeah, we gotta get Silver Fox fixed. So that's what we doing. Now we're just waiting for the tow truck. So I will see you guys when the tow truck is here. Peace. Thank you, honey.
Thank you over there.
Yes, that's so cute. That's like where Monet work at. Yeah. It's like they're outside enjoying the little weather, the hot weather, scorching weather. But it feels good right now because it's hot. Yeah, for right now, we're about to go pick up my car. We're here at the Brake Master. They do mechanical work, so here to get my car. They said it was a belt, so I had to get my belt to redone.
$187.86.
$187.86.
It's supposed to change the
watch.
$48.45.
That's
the full service, which is the conventional.
But that wasn't the synthetic, was it? Conventional. Okay. Oh, yeah, it went up. Your prices went up? Yeah, that's what I told you.
Full synthetic's technically cheaper.
How much is a synthetic?
$49.95.
Because
they have the $30 off coupon. There's no coupons for conventional.
So y'all conventional prices went up.
Correct.
Okay, this is July specials.
Yeah.
So free AC chain. Oh, we got free AC chains. That's what I need. The free AC chain. And the recharge is $15 off. Full and flush, save $24 versus $94.99. What's that?
So what's going on with the AC?
It's not coming on. It comes on, then it runs, and then it goes out until like a warm.
So then I can do an evac and recharge on it. It starts at $189.95.
Not right now.
No, I don't. Okay. I'm saying I could do one, but I want to do the free AC check first just to see if I can visually see anything.
Okay.
And is it something you were planning on?
Come back for that.
Yeah, no doubt.
Okay. the inflation is kicking our tails.
It's kicking everybody.
Yes. How, what do you think about the inflation? It's terrible.
It is what it is.
Do you have to work more hours or pick up another job or something?
I don't live outside my means. So.
Okay. Wow. Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Exactly. Mm-hmm.
I don't live outside my means. So to me, it is what it is.
Yeah.
I mean, I could not work for 2 years and still have money. So.
Right. That's right.
We just left the car complete right here.
So we got the car fixed, but I still have to. They put the Servitine belt on, so that was like, plus the oil change all together was like 180. But the belt, for them putting the belt and replacing the belt, it was 130. How much was it?
126.
126. And then it was like $50 for the oil change. But we got Dusty Busty back. We have to see what's going on with the air conditioning.
Well, probably that's why I was trying to just have to like chill.
We could always ask the other guy.
Because it's probably going to work now. It's probably going to work now. So you have to look that up.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a beautiful day. The mountains. Where we getting our, we get some apartments right there. Right next to Walmart. What they say?
What'd that say? This is what I thought it was. It was a gasket, an oil filter.
Uh-huh.
You know, he said they put a new one in.
Oh, okay.
Well, turn your air
off,
the air.
Okay. My damn lights on, the ABS light on, the tire suppressor light on, the check engine light on, and then the...
That's the traction.
Traction is on.
Okay.
Something's going on with like the sensor.
Yeah. Right, I'll let my guess
know. Okay. Hi, my Mika family. If it's not one thing, it's one thing. You know how to say, if it's not one thing, it's the... But I just want to say this one thing, because I don't want to jinx myself. But yeah, I gotta get Silver Foxes. Need a lot of repairs, and I'm gonna just go ahead. It seems like you have to do repairs or whatever as soon as you get finished paying your vehicle. It's been almost a year since I paid my vehicle off, so things start to kind of, you know, shutting down. It's just like the body, you got to repair it. Repair with nourishments and things that's gonna help the problem, help the issue.
Bro, I'm so tired of working, bro. I don't care about these bills, bro. I don't care about this freaking car, bro. I don't care about this freaking car insurance, bro. I don't care about these kids. But I don't care about my hair. I'm so tired of getting that.
Hello, this is my JV. I'm not a pleasure speaking with.
I'm just tired. Okay, I can have a
decision
with that. I'm just tired.
Tired. Can't even explain it. So tired on multiple levels. I'm just so tired. I'm so tired. I don't even want to talk about it anymore.
When you tell someone you're tired of working, the first thing they do is call you lazy. They call you soft. or they call you crazy. Like, how dare you reject the same programming that I accepted? How dare you reject the same script they gave me? They told us to finish high school, go to college, find a good job, retire at 65 years old, and that's exactly what I'm gonna do. And I'm just like, okay. If that's the life you want, by all means, I hope you become the manager, the CEO, become the best employee you can be. Cool, you can have it. But understand, everyone doesn't want that. Everyone doesn't believe in the American dream like you do. I mean, we live in America, right? The land of the free. So shouldn't a man or woman be able to say, you know what? I want to exercise my freedom and get out of this rat race. I don't want to do this the rest of my life. Maybe I have to do it for a period of time to save and build my own business or whatever I have to do, but I don't want to participate in this rat race. And if we
came to the realization, a bitch just don't want to work. And don't. I hate it. I don't know how people can sit at a job for working 8 hours a day. I don't even know how motherfuckers can work 40 hours a week, because I hate it. I literally hate it, especially working for somebody else. Like, if my job offer VTO, will be taking it quickly. I don't care, because I don't be having the mental capacity to sit at somebody else's job for 8 hours a day. I don't. I have very low attention span, and half of the time I just don't be paying attention. Like, I'm sick of it. Like, I feel like this new generation, none of us don't want to work for real. Like, our moms and, you know, moms and dads and grandparents did. They went to work, but nowadays we don't want to work. I want to make money another way, because just having to just deal with people, especially if you want customer service, deal with customer service, it's a lot. Like,
we get up every day and work to pay bills. We are not living to live. We are living to survive. And I still can't wrap my head around that. I also felt that.
That a 9-to-5 job is probably the worst schedule that you could possibly ever have. Think about it. Let's say somebody has to travel 30 minutes to go to work. You'd have to leave your house between 8:15 and 8:30, depending on traffic, and 8:15 is just playing it safe. And then you leave work around 5 in hopes that you get home without any issues. But everyone and their mother leaves at 5 o'clock as well, which means there will probably be traffic, which also means you will probably be getting home around 6 o'clock. I don't know about anyone else, but when I leave work and I get home, I can't just jump right into my 5 to 9. I have to unpack my bag, let my dogs out, change out of my work clothes, feed my dogs, and then feed myself, then finally sit down and start working on my 5 to 9, which ends up actually being more like 7:38 to 11. And that's if I choose to lose sleep or not. But this is all why a 9-to-5 job just hinders so much of your life, and also why you shouldn't continue to let a 9-to-5 job control your life. In my opinion, there is nothing good that comes out of a 9-to-5 job. For those of you who work that schedule, like, I fucking get why you feel like you have no time to do anything. But I'm also telling you right now that you do not have to feel stuck in your 9-to-5, and you do not have to stay there for the rest of your life. I know starting a business is super challenging when you have a 9-to-5 schedule. If you decide to learn to be your own boss, start opening yourself up to what's out here, you could leave your 9-to-5 job within a year. Imagine going all in on your goals and your dreams and not taking no for an answer, never giving up what you truly want to do in life, and then to be able to give your boss that 2-week notice, no longer needing that job because you took a chance to go all in on your dreams, and you were able to make 5 figures a month, which is obviously going to be more than what your 9-to-5 job pays you. So stop sleeping on your dream life and stop letting your 9-to-5 job control you, because there is so much more out here for you. And honestly,